You might know Africa as a continent of safaris, happy people, slums, AIDS, war, and poverty. It's all there, but there's also much more that you don't know about or have never seen of Africa.
Kenya is a country in East Africa, and its capital city is Nairobi. It became independent from the United Kingdom in 1963, and its first president was Jomo Kenyatta. It's a country with 34 million people, and 65% of them live in poverty. It's famous for its tourism industry and agriculture, supplying you with coffee, tea, and fruits like pineapple. They are then sold in shops, stalls, supermarkets, or sold abroad. Kenya is home to the Great Rift Valley, many wild animals, beautiful wild parks, and a lot of development.
Wat ziet u voor zich als u denkt aan een ontwikkelingsland?
Nou, mensen die honger hebben en vooral geen water en oorlog.
Oké. Zou u in zo'n land willen wonen?
Nee.
Nee. Nee, niet permanent.
Nee. Maar wel voor een tijdje misschien.
Je hebt geen inkomsten daar. Dus je kan reizen.
Ja.
Maar daar werken. Nee, laat die mensen maar zelf hun land besturen.
En wat denkt u dat ze niet hebben in een land zoals Kenia bijvoorbeeld?
Daar hebben ze al geen voorziening.
En dat
uitkeringen, internetvoorzieningen.
Nou, de eerste levensbehoeften, eten, schoon water en een dak boven hun hoofd.
Wat ze niet hebben. Poe. Jongen. Nou, de mensen op het platteland, nou, die hebben geen sinaasappelsap in liter pakken. Mogelijkheid om een heel groot assortiment van het fruit wat wij hier in de winkels hebben, zoals meloenen van Argentinië of ananas uit Costa Rica, dat hebben ze niet ter plaatse.
Nee, okay.
In de grote steden, wat ze niet hebben, nou, kernwapens misschien.
Oh ja,
I'm the hot stepper, I'm the super topper, I'm the true rocker, thanks to my creator. I'm the hot stepper, I'm the super topper, I'm the true rocker, thanks to my creator. Ningependa kutuma sana kwa watu wote wanapenda hizi ngoma. From Nairobi, Mombasa, Kisumu, Kampala, Arusha, na Dar es Salaam. Everybody wanna do the helicopter. Look at me, hey, sirimu noma. Kenya, hakuna matata. It's getting hot in here.
So what is your profession?
So I'm a tourist consultant by profession.
And what did you study?
I studied tourism management for 2 years in college. And subsequent attachment 6 months for industrial training. That aside, I also learned German and French, which I know is going to complement my career.
And is it hard to get work in Kenya?
Yes, I can say that as it is right now, it is very hard to find work in Kenya because, first of all, the number of people who are fully highly qualified for the different kind of professions that we have far much outweigh the opportunities that are there currently.
Okay. What is your tribe?
So my tribe is called Luo. We come from the lakeside region, that is Lake Victoria, on the western side of the country. And Kenya is a country of 43 tribes. All these 43 tribes speak Swahili as a national language altogether, and they also speak English as their official language. So at any given one moment in time and space, a Kenyan speaks at least 3 languages. That is his mother tongue, Swahili, and then English.
Why did you decide to go to Kenya?
One station which is very interesting because of the animals.
Wildlife, great
yeah.
Nature.
The only reason I'm here is for lots of leopards and the predators, animals, that's it.
Well, actually, I think the reason was that we had a friend who lived in Rwanda and we decided to visit him, so Kenya was a part of that trip.
What did you expect of Kenya before you booked your ticket?
Plenty of guides. That's it, plenty animals and a little bit of a backward world country, and that's about it.
Okay.
Just adventure.
Yes.
I had absolutely no idea.
No?
No.
And all you just hear the stories, standard Africa, and you're alive.
Different. It's very, the difference is in the people, because many of them are well dressed, they have suits, and the other side there are slums and people who don't earn a lot of money, so it's very difficult. It's different than in
me, lies in the extreme activity of all the people, yeah. Busy all the time, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. It's
always walking.
traffic.
The traffic.
It's similar to the rest of Africa. I come from Johannesburg, so similar type of situation. So I don't think nothing surprising at the moment. The crime is probably less here than in Johannesburg at the moment. That's it.
What did you expect of Kenya before you booked your ticket?
What did I expect?
I don't know. I didn't have much. I just knew that I was going to be outside in like a safari with all the animals and see the landscape. See the, like that's what the tribes, how the tribes live.
And were you surprised when you entered Kenya?
No, I was actually surprised in a positive way because the airport, outside the airport, has like this savanna feel, like the entire country you expect it to be. And I thought it was very pretty. It was like, wow, I'm in Africa, I've never seen this landscape before in my life.
Okay.
And I think that's something very typical from here.
Did you expect to see a lot of poverty?
Yes, I did, and I haven't seen that much poverty, to be honest with you, but it's probably because I just came from the airport to here.
Okay.
And always in big cities, there's not that much poverty.
Okay.
I was actually surprised that I think it wasn't that. Give a little whistle, make it a little you-hoo.
A very big difference between the villages and the cities in Kenya. I think you experience quite a high level of development when you get into the cities that you do not experience when you are out into the villages, although there is also a very strong cultural tie when you are out in the villages than when you are in the cities.
Okay. Is it hard to get work in Kenya?
Yes, it is not easy. There is a lot of unemployment, but things are changing. People are very creative in creating new jobs. Education is on a high level. Since a few years we have free education, so many people are able now to study and jobs are coming, although still a lot of people are not employed. But like I say, things are changing, new companies are coming in, people are investing in this country because it is very much worthwhile to invest. There is a lot of labor available.
How is Kenya developing and growing?
When you see, I've seen only for the last 4 years what is happening in the country. Like I say, there is free education. because of that foreign companies are coming into Kenya, they have trust in the economy in Kenya. People are starting to invest. And also when you see this year, for the first time, they made a budget, the government made a budget, and they don't need foreign aid anymore. In the past they were much reliable on foreign aid, but since this year the government earns enough taxes to pay all their costs. So when you say, is this country developing? Yes, for sure, it is.
On the 7th of August 1998, there were bombings on the American embassy in Nairobi. 257 people were killed and thousands of people were injured.
Do you think Kenya has too much poverty?
At the rate you are going, I think Kenya is coming out of poverty. About 70% of the people, they live in poverty, but 30%, maybe they are rich, they can afford everything. We get some assistance from the UN nations, some countries are poor, That is helping the Kenyan people a lot to get out of poverty. So I think by the time our estimate is 2020, Kenya will be a developed country.
Do you think Kenya has too much poverty?
Yeah, but not really. We are actually half-half. We're not really so pure as it seems. It's just that poverty is concentrated on the other side rather than on the minimum side, the middle side for all the people around.
How do you think people in Europe and USA think about Africa?
Many people in Europe, USA and other developed countries, they think that Africa, African people, they live in poverty. Many of the people live in poverty. Yes, we accept they live in poverty, but there also a percentage where people somehow can develop themselves. They are rich, they can also do things themselves. They think there are people, African blacks, many African people also are, many are thieves. They fear coming to Africa. But what I want to tell them is that Africa is a good country. Africa is a good continent. It has also many places where a European can come and be comfortable with.
Actually, I think that mostly they don't really know a lot about Kenya, because all they look is up to the government, but they don't really look up to the local people, because the local people are the ones who are really Kenyans, because the politicians is just their status that they are there. But they're only seeking how their politics is going on, but they're not looking on the other side of how the real people are really taking the issues as they are supposed to be.
If we talk about Africa, we talk about poor people living in huts or slums. But there are also people who live here.
Mama was queen of the Mambo, Papa was king of the Congo.
Here.
Deep down in a jungle, I start banging my first bongo. Every monkey like to be in my place instead of me, cause I'm the king
some
of bongo.
Some people have to buy their food
the
here.
Bongo bongo. I went to the big town where there
and some
is
people
a lot
can
of
afford
sound.
To shop
from
in the supermarket.
To the city looking for a bigger crown. So I play my boogie for the people of big city, but they don't go crazy when I'm banging on my boogie. I'm the
king of the bongo, king of the bongo.
Hear me when I come, baby.
King of the bongo, king of the bongo.
People who don't have a car,
nobody like to be in
can take
a
matatu.
Instead of me, cause nobody go crazy when I banging
a
on
bus.
My boogie. I'm a king without a crown, hanging loose in a big town. But I'm a king of bongo,
or a tuk-tuk.
Baby. I'm the king of bongo
bongo. King of the bongo, king of the bongo.
Hear me when I come, baby.
The Kenyan television has 7 channels.
Hear me when I come. They say that I'm a clown, making too much dirty sound. They say there is no place for little monkey in this town. Nobody like to be in my place instead of me, cause nobody
internet
go
is
crazy
fable
when
country,
I'm
right?
On my boogie. I'm the
king of the bongo, king of the bongo.
And also wireless internet is
hear
available.
Me when I come, baby.
King of the bongo.
For tourists, there are large hotels.
Hear me when I come, banging on
and
my
you can
bongo,
even skate
swing
on an ice rink
so
if it's too warm outside.
There's nobody in my place instead of me. I'm a king without a crown, hanging loose in a big town. I'm the king of bongo, baby. I'm the king of bongo bongo.
King of the bongo, king of the bongo.
How would you compare Holland
hear
to
me
Kenya?
When I come, baby.
Actually, yeah, Holland is so much more developed as I compare to Kenya. But Kenya has a certain strengths in its own capacity as a third world country. The country has some very beautiful scenery. It is quite interesting to see. We have lots of wildlife that is found in their natural habitat. We have very close-knit communities, something that I don't really experience in Holland. But Holland, infrastructure-wise, is so well-developed and way above what we do have in Kenya. The roads are very good. Yeah, you know, you have electricity, accessibility of electricity in almost every part of the country. We still don't have electricity in some parts of the country here. And there is very little challenge left as to what you can be able to do on your own in the country like Holland. Mm-hmm. Here the country is still very open and wide to many opportunities. You can still, I can say, for example, you know, like housing, you still don't have restrictions as to you have to adapt a particular style and particular color in a particular area. Something that I did experience in Holland, and you still have at least something to think about and to come up that will be new in Kenya as compared to Holland.
Tell me something about your life and your work here.
My life, I think in Kenya, sometimes it's quite tough to find a good job, white collar jobs. So many youth like me tend to go to crime, but mine was quite different. I had to find my own way of making my day-to-day bread, my daily living go well. So I decided on parking vehicles, giving service. That's why I came to get used to all to some people. And then because of the problem of parking, they normally leave their keys with me. And then I just park their cars for them. And then in return, they give me a token. It's not fixed. It normally depends with someone's will.
Okay, so they pay you?
Yeah, they just pay me depending on the will of someone. Because you see, people are quite different. Some will even come and maybe give you 10 bob. Some will even come and call you trash, parking boys. But I wonder how someone can come and leave his car keys to a parking boy. He has to leave it to someone who's responsible, because I think a car is something, someone treasures. You don't just go giving your important items to parking boys. Like a car. A car is quite expensive. It can get damaged. So you have to give it to someone who's responsible, and this is what they normally do.
Do you think Kenya has too much poverty?
Yes, I do. But the rate of poverty in Kenya is too high.
Okay.
Yeah.
And do you think it will become less in the future?
I don't think so, because those who are rich, they always rich, and they become more richer than those who are poor. So I don't think whether the poor will come to that standard, so that rate of poverty will be less low.
I think the poverty gap is moving wider and wider. Because you see in Kenya we have this trend that whoever was rich 20 years ago get on becoming richer and richer with his family and kids, you see. And someone who was poor some time back will get poorer and poorer. So, and I think the poverty level in Kenya is quite high. Maybe, let's say, 70-80% do live under the poverty line.
Do you think in the future, in about 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years, will it become less, the poverty?
I think maybe with the political will, it can, but I don't foresee the political will in our politicians.
Okay.
Yeah.
How do you think people out of Europe and USA think about Kenyans and the Kenyan country?
Not very much, because you see, whenever, even if they think about Kenya, unless Kenyans themselves think about themselves first, the rich Kenyans should think about the poor Kenyans more than what we can depend with the US or the European countries. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So it's upon Kenyan rich to change their trade and be kind and donative to the poor.
Yeah.
To my opinion is that the people in Europe and US, they think that Kenya, okay, they know that people are poor, and sometimes they think that people in Kenya, maybe some of them are, because of their poverty, their thugs, you know, the corruption, because of the poverty in Kenya.
become less in the future?
Yes, for sure. You know, when you see how quick things are changing, to give you an example, what is very popular, of course, everywhere in the world, but that is the IT. 10-12 years ago, there was no mobile phone in Kenya. At the moment, already 5 to 6 million people are subscribing to mobile phones. It's a country with 33 million people, so it is growing very fast. When you see what kind of new industries are coming up, for sure, people will have jobs. You know, at the moment it's still a big difference between the rich and the poor, and there is no middle class. And that is what you see, what is starting developing.
Do you have something to add to that?
Yeah, actually, what we have experienced in the past years is when the rural areas are also opened up infrastructure-wise, the towns and the areas have been able to develop very fast. Most of the high poverty levels have been found in the rural areas, where people live on about $1 a day. But with the opening up of the sections, the country is really developing. And for sure, I believe that in the future, with the kind of resources that are available in the country, there will be almost no poverty in Kenya.
Kenya is a country of contrasts. Some people are living in poverty, and some people live a luxurious life. It has almost everything that most developed countries have, but not everyone can afford them. And this is the same in Tanzania, South Africa, Botswana, Mozambique, Ghana, Nigeria, Cameroon, Uganda, Angola.
I wish I knew how it would feel to be free. I wish I could break all the chains holding me. I wish I could say all the things that I should say. Say them loud, say them clear, for the whole round world to hear. I wish I could share all the love that's in my heart. Remove all the bars that keep us apart. I wish you could know what it means to be me. Then you'd see and agree that every man should be free. I wish I could give all I'm longing to give. I wish I could live like I'm longing to live. I wish I could do all the things that I can do, though I'm way overdue. I'd be starting anew. Well, I wish I could be like a bird in the sky. How sweet it would be if out my heart I could fly. I'd soar to the sun and look down at the sea. Then I'd sing, 'cause I know, yeah. And I'd sing, 'cause I know, yeah. And I'd sing, 'cause I know.